Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you so much for making time and joining the Redington webinar sessions. Today's topic we have from Barracuda, and Ravi Patwala, who will be presenting the session to you. Ravi, over to you.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining. Hope everyone is safe. Today, I want to talk about some of the best practices, strategies around the remote worker, especially related to email threats in face of this COVID-19 situation. Clearly, these are some difficult times, and we all know we are in this together. Due to this major pandemic outbreak, we are getting into the new normal of working, which is working from home. And we are all aware about the situation around the world. Most of the country and the state is going into the partial lockdown, if not complete. And they have changed the way we do our business and how we work, and that poses a new challenges and how to remain productive. So what are the impact of this outbreak, not only in world, but let's look at about the Middle East. So around March 12 or 13, WHO declared the coronavirus as a pandemic, and after that, the first country which become to stop all the commercial flight is Kuwait. Then following, Abu Dhabi allowed his government employee to work from the home. And so Saudi Arabia also followed the process, and finally Dubai airport is shut down for the public transport. So these are the impact that have, and this has clearly implication on our businesses and how we approach to our businesses. And also, it is important in the next week or month how you are going to approach the businesses and ensure that all the employees remain protected and also they remain the productive. So what does this mean in terms of the business and continue to have the success of our businesses? So of course, there are challenges when the office worker goes to the home and they started to work on the remote side. There are personal challenges and business challenges. And the main concern is how to make them effective, how to make them remain productive. And it is difficult. We know that there are personal challenges. If we look at, we are worried about the family, kids, and how to remain safe in this kind of situation. And of course, working in this chaotic situation and remain productive. And there are a lot of distraction as well in terms of personal challenges. And when we look at from the business side, the main thing is for the IT team to manage the home user if they faces any challenges. Just for example, 1 week ago, my laptop was, I was not able to turn it on, and I had to call the IT guy how what to do. And it took almost 30 minutes for me to figure out what was the issue. If we were in office, this would have been resolved in 5 minutes only. So this stretches the IT to its limit, and it is very difficult time for the IT team as well. Of course, it has disrupted the supply chain, how we deal with our vendors, our partners, and a partner deal with the customer, the hardware delivery, all the supply chain has been disrupted because of this. And finally, all the communication has gone virtual, and the document sharing and whatever it is, everything is on email. And that possesses the more threat than before to protect the emails. Needless to say that increase of distraction and anxiety that employees facing right now, I'm sure most of you have never worked so long from the home, and in this leading to a working from home, as I mentioned earlier, taking care of personal situation while ensuring that we remain productive. This lead to the higher susceptibility of the email attack. As we know that email was already one of the prime weapon of the hackers to get into the any organization. But as we are working from home, and I will share you some of the insight of the threats from the email that is occurring due to this COVID-19 situation. And what are the implications of it? And some of the best practices that you can use and you can share with the customer to overcome this kind of threat. And this will also put a less load on you to resolve the customer issues. Now, I'm sure that most of you are right now working from home. Maybe your company has decided. If not, then maybe they are in the process of it or they have already planned it. So when we look at the most the breaches that start with the email, this is a 2018 report that suggests that 93% of the email starts, 93% of the attack starts with the email. As I said, email remain the number one threat of for the hacker to get into the any network. Of course, there are various ways to get into the into the organization, but social engineering present the 93% of the email breaches. Now, what is social engineering that I will discuss in detail, and how hackers are leveraging this kind of technique to launch into the attack. And as we speak in the time of crisis, it become more easy for the hacker to launch an attack using this kind of technique. They are leveraging this social engineering, and also this 2018 report suggests. But this is really unfortunate, as many of the attack are slipped through the email security. They really target the vulnerable employee, and that lead to the loss of financial data, obviously financial loss, and potentially brand damage. So it can be quite serious. Now, I'm going to talk about the COVID-19 email attacks. So these are the information that I have gathered from the Barracuda and the team. What we have seen in past 2 months, especially in February and starting of the March, what kind of attack that we have observed on the customer. That I'm going to share the more detail about this. So some of you might be aware about the email security gateway who have worked on the email security gateway. So as you know, that email security gateway is provide a protection where you have the email server, which is located in the customer premises, which has the physical device or a virtual appliance. It will provide you protection against the spam, malware. It has the antivirus and allows the legitimate email. And some of the email security gateway even provide protection against the zero-day attack as well. So this is the traditional email security. What we are talking about is, which was you were useful 5 years ago or 10 years ago. But as the hacker grew, there it was a requirement of the email security, which is adaptive and able to detect the new attack. So what are the modern threats that we are talking about? So brand impersonation is the number one threat. So is business email compromise. And there are other new attacks that we have discovered in last few months. And one of the main of them is the conversation hijacking. Now I'm going to discuss about this attack in detail. So is the account takeover. So whatever these modern threats that we are seeing, these are the threats that we have seen become quite popular in last few years. Now, if I talk about for 5 years ago, the hacker was using a normal phishing email. They will send a bulk email to the multiple organization to trick them, maybe to send a phishing link, and user will provide the username and password, and then the hacker will have that information, maybe bank account information or a different login detail which hacker requires. But after the creation of the zero-day attack, and which is very popular amongst the hacker as well, and that was the beginning of the change in the attacks, and it is a new tactic that hacker has adopted, and now no one is sending a normal spam email to the organization where they want to gain some specific or very useful information. And they really switch gear in few years, and they are always ahead than the security vendor, if I'm not wrong, because of the tactics they are using. So enter this decade, and especially few years back, we started to see these modern attacks. For example, account takeover attack. So what in account takeover happened is, they get the information of the login credential by different techniques. So major techniques remain the brute force attack, where they use the cyber criminal develop the automated script to crunch through the password combination and hoping to generate the successful login key. And that is the brute force as a script. Second one is spear phishing. Now, what is the difference between the phishing and spear phishing? It is very important to understand. We all know that what the fish look like. It has the URL. Maybe it is look like the same as the any website name, but it might be missing some one of the word in from that URL. But using the spear phishing technique, they will trick the user to share the personal information. Now what happens is the spear phishing is like a targeted attack. So before sending a harmful link, they will start communicating with the victim and they will start sending a harmful email before they actually send a phishing email. So it is very difficult to identify this kind of attack because it is specifically designed for one user only. It is not sending to random people around the world or in one organization. Maybe they are sending information to HR, a marketing team or a financial team to get the information about the company data. The third one which I want to talk about is the social engineering. As I discussed, 93% of the hacker now is using social engineering technique. So what they do, they spend time on the research of a specific social media platform, maybe Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, whatever Instagram is available, and they look for the information of the victim about their name, their location, their phone number, even they go on to find the name of the family member and anything that assists them in guessing the password. Maybe some of the user is using a password as the bank account password as a birth date or a combination of the family person with the birth date or maybe a number plate of the vehicle. So this is what the hacker is looking after in social engineering attack, and it's this attack takes time. It is really time consuming and requires a lot of effort as well. So maybe it takes 5-6 months before they actually launch an attack into the specific organization. The fourth technique for the account takeover is the botnet. So what they do in botnet, they will deploy one specific software which we call as a bot for the customer account. They will plug the commonly used password and username to perform a rapid attack and take the maximum number of account as they can, all staying hidden for the immediate view because the bot deploy from the multiple location. It is not easy to identify bot. It is different than the brute force attack because in brute force attack, they will send a script from one specific IP, whereas in bot, they will send a they will try to hack using a different combination of username and password from different location. So it is very harder to identify this kind of attack using malicious IP address login. And lastly, I want to talk about is the credential stuffing for the account takeover. So what credential stuffing is, it's nothing but a credential stolen from a leak website. Maybe one of the website gets leaked, for example, Netflix or any other Amazon Prime. What they do, they just publish this record on specific platform, or you can even purchase this kind of database which has the username and password on a dark web. And then you can test this username and password on multiple websites in hope of catching a victim who hasn't realized that the login information has already been compromised. And we know every day we read in the news, there's this much of credit card has been revealed by this specific organization. Maybe we are using a website where we are doing an online purchase and that website get compromised. So this is all the information is available on the dark web and you can even purchase that and then you can use it. Then I would like to talk about the business email compromise. Now this is the email attack that right now hacker is using. What we have seen after mid-March, they have started to use business email compromise attack. In combination with this COVID-19 situation, they are leveraging this situation. So what happened in business email compromise? Attacker obtained the access of a email account which looks like similar to the original account. Maybe only one word would be different, or even when you get an email, it looks like the same email, exact username and exact domain. But when we check the header, it's only word different in the header. So often they create this kind of account with the email address which looks identical to the corporate network, and they rely on a assumption that there is a trust between the victim and the email address from which they are sending an email. And this kind of business email compromise attack, also sometimes called as a man in the email attack. You might have heard man in the middle, but the business email compromise also sometimes called as a man in the email attack. Now, this is the domain registration for past 2 months that we have get the information. So what they are, we see in this graph is the website registration, domain name registration in the name of coronavirus. There are different website which is getting registered to share the information about the coronavirus. What are the symptoms, as we know, or maybe they are providing information about from where we can get this equipment like face mask, sanitizer, what to do, what not to do. Each country has put up a portal, as we know about this. And as we know that most of this domain are legitimate to use, but some of them are using for the malicious intent. And believe me, most of the customer is not aware about this, because even the organization itself, they are sending the information about the coronavirus to spread the awareness. So now it is become very difficult to identify which is the genuine website and which is not. And hacker is actually leveraging this information. So as you can see in the starting of the February, from 9 to 21, there are registration between 50 only, but as we move to the March, it has increased drastically, and now we see more than 500. And as we speak, I'm sure this number has increased to the more than 1,000 information. So even if you are getting any email for this kind of information about the awareness about the coronavirus, so it is important to check the authenticity of the website. So this is not related to webinar, just how you can check. You can go to the website, see whether it is secure website, has a HTTPS, it has a certificate, and then you can check the certificate of the website, whether it's signed by different or third root authority like VeriSign or Symantec. And then you will be able to identify whether this website is genuine or not. And this is again a graph that we have designed in the face of the COVID-19, the spear phishing attack that we have got from January to the mid-March. So as we know that in January, their situation wasn't that bad. It started to get bad after mid-February. And the spike which you see here, this is of the weekend. So hacker is also, they are also very smart. They are not sending a attack during the weekend. That's why the graph falls during the weekend, and it increased during the weekdays. And what kind of spear phishing attacks that they are sending, that I'm going to discuss about this in detail. And also, if you go onto the dark web, there is COVID-19 phishing kit is available. It's very easy now just to go there and purchase this kind of kit. Even they will educate you how to send the email information to the specific organization, what not to send in the email, and even they will train you and they will provide you support as well. So you might have heard about, you, most of you have seen this map of the COVID-19, and there was a news that even this website was also compromised, but then they have rectified that in information. And this is again the types of attack that we have seen in last 2 months. So what we have seen is in the starting phase of this situation, the attack was less personalized. That means it was a simple spam email that was hacker were using, maybe to just phish the victim and trick them so they will get to the specific website. But after that, what we have seen is this attack has become more sophisticated. They are taking advantage of this situation and user is not aware of it. And more than 50% of the attack are of spamming. So what does that do in the spamming? They are requests for the donation. And they know that most of the people right now, they want to help by anyhow. They want to donate, they want to spread awareness, they want to stay at home, but everyone wants to get out of this situation. They are doing a spamming by asking for the donation, or even they are offering a cure like sanitizer or face mask or some medicine. And even the investment opportunities, like we know that this business of face mask and sanitizer and shop is going to increase. They are sending the full proposal with all the information, where the factory is located, where you need to make the investment with account information. So these are the spamming scam that is going on right now. But apart from the scam, there are 34% is the brand impersonation. So if you have not heard about brand impersonation, is nothing again but to trick the user with the domain name. Like if it's a Microsoft, they will remove some Microsoft O, they will remove from the word O and they will send the email. So it looks like it is coming from the Microsoft. So this is nothing but brand impersonation. I'm going to talk about that in detail as well. Now, 11% of the attack is the blackmail emails. And these are the email that we have recently seen in March only. We haven't seen it before because nobody was using this kind of technique. So what they do, by social engineering, they are gathering the information of the person, private information, like what is their location of the house, who is their family member, what are the name of them, and then they are sending the information, say, if you do not send me this much of money, I will send this specific victim to your home or to your company and maybe it will be infected with coronavirus. So they are actually blackmailing the victim. And lastly, this business email compromise, you might see this one person, because these are highly sophisticated attack. It's not very easy to launch an attack using this technique because it requires a lot of efforts. So this is the example of the brand impersonation. Now, before I begin about this slide, I just want you to know that what is the domain name of a WHO? You can think about it. Most of us will think that WHO is a non-profitable organization and their email will be who.org. But if you just Google it, who.org, it will open one website which will redirect you to a different domain, which is a genuine WHO domain. So even if any user is looking at this email, which is coming from who.org, so everyone thinks that, okay, it's a ORG, which is non-profitable organization, so it must be genuine. But this is not the actual domain of a WHO. Actual domain for WHO is who.int, international. And I'm sure that most of the normal user won't be aware of it. And let's look at this example, what impersonation it is doing. It's saying, good morning, we are from WHO. We have this Dropbox link for the health advisory during the recent coronavirus situation. And it has shared this link. And this will show you that we have what is the best practices to remain uninfected. So it's very easy to trick this using this situation right now, what we are into. So this is what a brand impersonation look like. What we were seeing, that most of the time the brand impersonation was about the Microsoft, Apple, but now recently, not only WHO, but another organization which we see is a CDC. That is also now hacker is using as a impersonation. As you know, this is a brand impersonation. It is not the actual domain of a WHO. So we have identified this attack and it is going to specific Gmail domain. So these are the most impersonated brand recent time. Microsoft, of course, remains the number one because of Office 365. So is Apple because of the popularity. But as we know, we are going into the situation working from home. We are relying on this company like UPS, FedEx, where they are actually doing the transportation of our shipment movement, and we are continuously in touch with this kind of organization. So hacker is even leveraging the brand impersonation of this kind of organization as well. Again, the DocuSign, it is very important to understand because we don't know how long this situation is going to be. So all this documentation is going to be on virtual, and all the signing information about the contract, most of the organization already started on the DocuSign. So this is also one of the major target from the hacker to impersonate the brand. Now, business email compromise, as I discussed in one of the previous slide, that 1% of the email attack is coming from the business email compromise. So what they do is they trick the user, which on assumption that they trust this specific user, and they impersonate this user. And what they say quickly, what is the available balance on the company account? Also, we need to send the payment to the UK to fight against the coronavirus. As we know that a lot of country has requested for the fund from various organization, and everyone even sending the money to the relief fund. So it looks very genuine that, okay, everyone is going into the situation, and this hacker is actually sent the email to one of the accountant of the company, which is doing the wire transfer. So as we know that this is one of the business email compromise attack, which looks like it is coming from the executive of a company, but it's not. And this is the one of the latest attack that we have identified in last few months. And in terms of coronavirus situation, this getting very sophisticated, and user are using conversation hijacking attack to trick the user. So what happens? This is advanced level of attack from the business email compromisation. So by somehow hacker gets into the user, hacker gets the username and password of the account that they want by using a different technique, and then they search for the specific email, and they will look for the conversation history of the into the mailboxes. So they are not going to send an email directly once they get the access of the specific account. They will look for the history of the email, and they will see, most of the time they will see the financial data conversation where somebody is asking for the payment information. And after that, on that email, they will reply to the specific recipient that, okay, this is the what I have done. Okay, now send me the money onto this different bank account. Because of the COVID-19 situation, this bank branch is not working. So we have a different account in this different branch. So send me the money into this branch. And it looks very genuine that, okay, this branch is not working and this bank is not working, so I need to send money to the different account. So even if we have looked into the email history, the recipient is able to see all the communication of the email. So if we see the history, then we will have the information what we have sent. So it looks genuine. Even the most trained user who is aware about this kind of attacks that is going on can be tricked using this kind of conversation hijacking attack. So this is what they do into this. Now imagine if somebody send the huge amount of money using this, so it will be a huge impact on the company financial data and where we are struggling. So this is the perfect example of COVID-19 where they are adapting the way and they are doing the attack accordingly. So what are the security challenges that we face today that we have discussed? Spear phishing attack, they are exploiting this COVID-19 situation, and your number one concern should be how you will make sure that your customer will not fall into this trap, how you will educate them. That should be the main concern. So this lies the biggest security challenge right now about the COVID-19 email campaign that is going on, because there are genuine email campaign is also going on even from company HR team. So how you are going to identify that? And it's very easy for employee to fall into this kind of attack, again, because of lack of knowledge or even the anxiety that they are in. Everyone right now, what I see is there are bunch of videos that has been shared on the WhatsApp, and whatever their link is sharing, nobody knows whether it's genuine or not. So it's very easy for employee to fall into this kind of attack. And the most important thing is the IT, where there are lack of resources for the incident response. Now, imagine that the company which has the 1,000 users, they are going for the VPN solution where everyone is working from home. They might not be able to connect to the resources of the company. So their IT team is getting a call they need to resolve using a remote support. And in that kind of situation, if they are getting attacked, how they are going to respond to this kind of attack. So this is again the one of the biggest security challenges poses on the IT team. And employee which are distracted, they can reveal the sensitive information with the wrong people, and that will evenly put the company image onto the better side. And data loss, as we know that there are chances that if the employee is falling into this kind of attack, they might reveal the information. So how you are going to implement the DLP policy, data loss prevention. So if your customer is using the Barracuda product, then we have inbuilt DLP which you can configure. I will share the link with you after once this presentation is over, how to configure the DLP. Most of the email security solution, they offer the DLP as a free of cost. So it's not related only to Barracuda. It's important that you configure the DLP policy in correct way right now to stop user from revealing the important information. And lastly, the business and email continuity. This is the most priority for all the organization, how to remain their business productive and how to make it continuity with the email. If number one concern is email should not go down. So make sure that if your email is go down, you have some backup policy or some insurance policy. That also going to discuss how Barracuda can help you in the email continuity. Now, what are the best practices during this crisis that I want to offer you, or what Barracuda has offered you? So this is basically, there are three pillars for right now in this situation: technology, people, and business continuity. This is not a time to do the intervention of any network security appliance and configure the policy for the IT team. It has to be automated. There has to be a configuration of policy where there are less false positive, and the detection, prevention, and the incident response all has to be the automated. We cannot depend on a IT guy who is managing this solution and think that he is going to make sure that everything is working fine. Now, again, if some of your customer will not have a solution for this kind of incident response solution, we understand it's not the right time to purchase a new solution, but how Barracuda can help you, that I'm going to discuss later. Make sure that encryption policies configure for the top executive of the employee. So is the DLP policy. And of course, we cannot forget the people. They are the epic center of this situation. So what we can offer, the security awareness training. There are solutions available which provide the simulation of the phishing. I have one slide which will show you what the phishing email look like. And this is the right time to educate the user, because once they are, first they are working from home. So all the user will have more time to educate themselves about this kind of attack than ever. And lastly, the business continuity. So when it comes of business continuity, you need to have the cloud backup. If your production goes down, what is going to happen? So it's important that you have the cloud backup and the email continuity. If your email server itself goes down, make sure that we have the insurance policy. Now, again, I have already discussed in terms of this is about the technology that what we can offer. I already discussed this traditional email security. Now, why it is not enough in today's world? It offers you the spam protection. It has the antivirus. It has the IP reputation, content filter, even advanced threat protection. Now, I know this all this method is really important to provide protection against the conventional threat. Even advanced threat protection will provide you protection against the conventional threat that is there, but it's not going to provide you protection against the new threat that we have discussed. So clearly, email security gateway is not the solution right now for the protection of the email. Why? Because there is a social engineering that going on. It can easily bypass the email security gateway. Now, it is very unfortunate that this email security gateway are not able to identify, because first, it's an old technology. Second, it's on-premise technology. And thirdly, it is very difficult to integrate with the Office 365. There are hardly any solution which offers the API-based integration. So what we need is for the Office 365, especially I'm talking about the Office 365. I'm sure that most of the SMB customer are on Office 365. So what we need is an API-based security. Why? Because Microsoft have open API for the Office 365 mailboxes. So if you have a technology, you can directly integrate into the Microsoft Office 365. As a Barracuda, we have integrated our solution, which is a Sentinel, which is different, and it is only designed for Office 365 users only. I'm going to give you some information about that once the presentation is over. What is Sentinel? So what it does is it directly integrates with the mailboxes of the user. It not only resides like this email security gateway at the gateway level, it actually integrates with the mailboxes. What does that mean, integration with the mailbox? That means we have the information about all the emails, even the historical email. If today you are going to integrate our solution with Office 365, then we will have the information of all the previous email as well. So what we can do, we can identify the bad email or a spam email which is already there in the inboxes. Now you are not going to get this kind of protection with email security gateway. So this is what you see. This is what gateway, once it misses and once the spam is inside, gateway cannot do anything. So that is why we need a direct integration with the Office 365. And this is how it will help you to create the identity of the user. Now, what we do by integration, we are creating the one graph of the user. So let's discuss about that graph. What is actually this identity graph? So as you can see, there are different methods that we have. We create the identity graph of each user. You can say we are creating a profile of a user. Look, for example, location. What location this user is logged in from the past 1 year, or maybe from whenever this user has been activated. What kind of application that he's using? What kind of document it is receiving and sending? And what are the email addresses that it has the conversation? So by using this, we are creating a profile or identity graph of each user. Now, this is not only limited to what you see right now on the graph. There are hundreds and thousands of parameters by which we are creating the identity graph. What we do is we have the AI and ML, artificial intelligence and machine learning algorithm, which we are using to create the identity of the each user. And this identity will be unique for each user. So that way we will be able to identify the attacks which bypass the email security gateway, like business email compromise, a conversation history attack. So as you can see that these are the, for example, if one user has not logged in out of UAE for past 1 year, And when you see the hacker is, of course, he is not going, maybe it is in UAE, but maybe it's outside. So if we get the login detail from some specific country outside the UAE, so we understand this is not a normal behavior. This is abnormal behavior. And this is how we trigger that this can be a malicious activity. And even we can send a notification after that to the admin that this user has logged in from this specific IP address. Do you want to check what this user is actually logged in? And there are thousands of rules that you can create on the gateway, but you cannot use the machine learning to actually create the identity of the user. So when this unusual activity occur, and it will trigger the alarm because it's a different than the normal activity. And this is how this identity graph will help you to identify the abnormal behavior. Now, these are the attack which is highly targeted. So to understand that gateway can help you by creating a rule, but by creating a rule, for example, in gateway, you can create a rule by which location this user is allowed to log in, which email address it can send the email. But to detect it automatically, you need a AI and ML technology, which we have in the Sentinel. And especially now, the way we work right now from home, adoption of the automation is very important, and it requires the behavior-based approach. And if we talk about the gateway, it is very difficult to scale. If you have 2,000 thousands of users, it's very difficult for the IT admin to create a role for each user. So this is about the technology. The new technology that we have to offer to the customer is the security awareness training. Now the product name is the Barracuda Phishing Training product. So this is one of the example of the email that will be sent to the user. And as he suggests, it is coming from the New York, and it has the link and different information. Even you can create your own email and you can send it to the user. Now it's not only related to email, it has the different videos as well for the train the user, and you will get the report of each user. And then you will be able to identify, you need to educate which user and which user is more aware about this kind of attack. So security awareness training is also one of the best practice that we can use right now. And finally, the business continuity. Of course, data protection remains the number one priority for any IT team. Over-reliance on exchanges where your data is stored, and as we go, there is increased use of OneDrive, Shares, and Team. So we need to make sure that all the data which is there in the exchange or even Office 365 remain protected from the accidental or malicious deletion of the data. So this is again very important. And email continuity, just for example, we are providing, if you buy the Office 365 security solution from Barracuda, we are giving you 96 hours of spooling. So even if Microsoft data center goes down, you will have the email stored in Barracuda for 96 hours. So these are the kind of solution that is really the need of our right now, that make sure that your email communication remain uninterrupted regardless of what is your server, whether it's on-premise server or whether it's a Microsoft Office 365. So what should you do to check that your customer remain secure? Now, I know that this is not the time to offer you the new solution, and it will be very difficult for you to convince the customer to buy the new solution. So instead, what we are offering is we are giving you free email threat scanner. Now, what is it? It is nothing but our Sentinel product. I will share the link for this email threat scanner. Your customer doesn't need to make any changes into the Office 365. He doesn't need to change the TXT record, MX record, DMARC, anything. What we need is just the admin credential of Office 365 user, and then we will give you the report. That's it. So customer will be able to identify whether existing email security solution for Office 365. Now, when I say Sentinel, it is only for Office 365. So then customer from the report will be able to identify whether he has purchased a good solution from the Microsoft or from any other third vendor. And even I can help you in that by explaining the report to the customer. So then the continuous education of the customer employees also remain the number one priority, and make sure that your encryption policy for the top executive is configured properly. So is DLP policy, and to make sure that backup is enabled for all the emails, so that actually it prevents the accidental data and also the continuity of the email if any of the email server goes down. So lastly, just I want to thank you everyone for attending this presentation. Stay safe where you are, and let me know if you have any question. I'll be happy to help you.
Thank you so much, Ravi. I'm just checking if there are any questions. Yes, we have one question, Ravi. Just check the published section. Okay, the question was just that they were not able to understand you, and if you could speak a little slower. We will definitely take this feedback forward, and I think in the upcoming sessions we will make sure that you know the voice and everything is audible and all of you are able to understand and listen properly. Thank you everybody for making the time and you know listening to the entire session. We have a lot of other webinars which are scheduled for the entire month, and we will keep sending you guys the invites, and y'all can see whatever is relevant or whatever product is relevant for you guys and attend the sessions. Hope all of you are home, safe and sound, and have a great day.